22nd October 1934, Upper Wickham Lane in Welling witnessed the opening of the first purpose-built Odeon cinema designed by architect George Cole. The cinema, after serving the community for 26 years, closed in 1960. It was reopened in 1961 as a top-ranked bingo club, which later became a Mecca bingo club. The future of this historic building was left in the balance when the national ban on smoking in public places forced the club to close in 2007. After its closure, the building, due to neglect, was vandalized and taken over by squatters. Within months of neglect, a once vibrant community pride has suddenly become an eyesore. In March 2009, 2 years after its closure, Freedom Center International, a multicultural Czech-based charity in Peckham, led by Dr. Sharak Ofusuwari, a pastor, teacher, and visionary, took the bold step to purchase and restore 38 Upper Wickham Lane back to its former glory. This time not as a cinema or a bingo hall, but a church and a community facility.
At Freedom Center International, we believe that the church must be very relevant to the community in which it's based. And this is what we've been doing for the past 13 years, integrating with the community, helping the youth, helping young people, helping old people, helping women, those who are disenfranchised and disadvantaged in society, to come to see the worth in themselves and how they can get on with their lives. And we've been doing this very effectively through our projects in Peckham, and hoping that we will do the same thing with our new project here in Welling.
To acquire the building, FCI organized fundraising activities through its membership. With no development finance in sight due to recession, the church had to take prudent strategies in the building development project.
We acquired this property in the recession, and we have had challenges doing it up, especially because the banks were not lending and so on and so forth. So after the acquisition, we had challenge raising the development loan to do it. But I thank God for the members of FCI who gave their time, gave their love, gave their money for this multi-million project to be made a reality. And we say that God bless every person who have contributed in cash, in kind, in love, giving their talents, make it very successful. And we thank God for their lives.
After receiving the approval from Bexley Council to change the use of the building, members of FCI, since 2009 to date, have volunteered their time to work with Radio Construction, the main contractors, as labourers, builders and consultants throughout the various construction stages of the project.
If people are willing to do something, they'll do it properly. They're willing to listen, follow the rules, the regulations, and I think there's something that they can be proud of, is having a pastor like this, a church like this, and even giving a hand. So they actually feel like it is their project, which is actually quite nice. They were very helpful in clearing up, moving things for us, and working with a small thing. Was also a bit of a challenge, but then again, we managed to get things done, and we did it well.
This project has undergone many phases. The concepts behind the design and refurbishment will restore as much of the original features as possible. But we also wanted to add a bit of a new and a modern twist to the project. And to do that, we thought of adding the band balcony, which required some the experts to come in and advise on how such a structure could be built. So I think the structural development was one of the most challenging part of the project, where we had the structural engineers, the architects coming in. We also had to sort planning permission to change that part of the building as well. And I think the exciting day was when the metals arrived, what we call the big metals, and it was good because we had all church members, all the men in the church, some taking lunch break from work and coming in to join us, lift the heavy metals. The highlight of this project for me was the arrival of our two containers from China. And most important was seeing this container now coming on site. Now a container that we have personally loaded and locked in China and had now arrived in the UK. And you could see the excitement. Everybody was on board, even the co-pastor, Pastor Dorothy herself, and Elder Mercy, you know, the two ladies amongst us were on site as well to just show their support to the guys as we offloaded this container. And I must say, the guys of the chair did fantastic. They didn't just offload the chairs, they also went ahead and helped to assemble these chairs, and they also installed them. There were instances on site where this place was just completely jam-packed with builders, with contractors. Yes, we had the sound guys putting up their sound equipment, Skylight Audio. We also had the electrical engineers, Amson, electrical contractors also doing the electrical bit. Painters were on site, builders all over the place. The site was completely busy, and sometimes we didn't even know who was doing what at some times. But in a nutshell, we'll say that this project has been a great success. And we can only say to God be the glory, because it's been hard work. In the spite of lack of finances, we still pushed through. And I think we must applaud Dr. Shadrach, because there were points of the project where we were thinking of holding off and saying that why don't we take a month or two whilst we put together some funding in order to carry on, but then he said no, this project must continue, and there was not an instant that we had to stop for even a day. We were thankful to the contractors, we are thankful to our suppliers, who were all understanding of our financial situation and stood with us whilst we developed this project to this state.
A lot of members that live in the vicinity, from Abbeywood, Thamesmead and Bexley, where they travel, they commute to Peckham all the time for services. So having a building like this in Welling would mean that they will not have to go all the way to Peckham. We can keep our Peckham congregation in Peckham, and the congregation here will be made up of all those who live in the vicinity. In so doing, we have become one church in two locations, and that is our slogan now. So we have Peckham congregation and Welling congregation, and these two churches or these two assemblies form one big congregation.
After 16 months of total commitment, 38 Upper Wickham Lane is reborn as a church and a community facility.
I know that this property is very dear to the community here. So we in a sense give the property back to the community, and when I say that, I mean we open our doors for the community. If they want to use it for any project or use the community for any community meetings, and the councillors, everybody's welcome, because we want the community to have ownership of this particular building, and we believe in that there will be good interaction between the church and the community in order for us all to build a very good place to live. Because we have such a big heart for the youth in this ministry, we're setting a youth church where all the young people can come together, and as friends and colleagues, they can interact and get to know one another and do what they do best, music and all the things they do. But also we're going to tailor-made youth services in the sense of the service we provide for the young people, advisory, career development. We want to make sure that we point them to the right direction so they become the somebodies in societies tomorrow. We want to put in structures to help them in mentoring, and a lot of the skills that people have in this ministry, we want to use those skills to help them. Those who want to go to accountancy, we've got accountants who will help them and direct them in the right path. Those who want to go to medicine, we've got medical people who will help them, direct them in the right path. Those who want to go into music and film production and all those things, we have all those expertise. We don't have a footballer though, so maybe we're going to help them in those things as well. But basically, we are here to do everything we can to give the youth a good image and bring them to their God-given goal in life.